Hey, what's up? My name is Adam, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up Substack. A lot of people are wondering about how to set up Substack, so I thought I'd make a quick video that explains what it is, how it's laid out, and then show you the process I use to set up our own Substack publication. Let's just dive right into the video. This is a platform that lets you develop an email list. So whenever you publish a post that you create in Substack, it will go to your subscribers' email list and it'll be available for other people on Substack. I'll just give you a sense of the layout here, which is a bit confusing. So right now you're on the Discover page. You can check activity, and I don't have activity yet. We haven't made any posts, but that's why nothing shows up here. It will when you start posting. Here's the profile section. So this is where we edit our company profile for Substack, and you can see kind of what the profile will look like. This is the one line tag. We haven't subscribed to anything yet. We haven't posted anything yet. Now, in order to go and configure your own Substack, go to the dashboard in the top right corner here. This is gonna show you what your homepage will eventually look like in a sense. It'll show you the posts and what they look like. It'll show you your draft section. It'll provide some resources about setting up your Substack. Now, to begin the process of setting up your Substack, go to your settings right here, click this button, and then this is where you can modify your publication name. So I've called our publication Discover Collaborations. The point of our publication is to provide an ongoing regular feed of links to collaboration opportunities using Kahana. So it's a way for you to learn and contribute to hubs and connect with people across multiple industries. This is the one-liner that's gonna appear on the Discover page that I just showed you, where everything appears for publications. So like it'll say Discover Collaborations, and you'll see this one-line description. This is also what it appears like on the welcome page. So if you click on Discover Collaborations, you're like, you're super interested in learning more, this is where you see our image and the name and the description, and you can give your email and subscribe. If you want to read our post first, you can. We don't have anything there, so it just says coming soon. Here's where you can add tags. This is how Substack's algorithm will recommend your publication. There isn't much information about Substack tags. We'll experiment and see what works. The About page is very important. This provides more information about your Substack publication. So I would recommend spending a good amount of time making sure your About section is doing your publication justice. And there's a lot of different little tricks to making it really engaging if you want to do that. I've seen About pages that are very simple and minimalist. I've seen ones that are very engaging. Ours needs to be engaging and informative because we have a different type of newsletter. Discover Collaborations is not a newsletter that is just stories that I'm writing as a stream of consciousness. It is a mechanism to give you a feed or a bi-weekly digest of new collaboration opportunities you can dive into. And that's essentially what we're describing here. We're providing opportunities to provide an email and subscribe. Here's the benefits infographic I created. Here's why it works, because we're leveraging the Kahana platform. If you don't know what it is, it's the name of this channel. It's a platform that is essentially GitHub for collaboration and knowledge sharing, except you don't have to code. It's for anybody who's not a developer to essentially have an open source ecosystem for collaboration. And it lets you just get started on any type of collaboration project that you want to do. This is a way for you to launch a new collaboration. It's a way for you to connect with people who are also trying to collaborate instead of kind of reaching out to people who are a bit busy. Like, this is a way for people to literally discover your collaborations. And that's why we called it Discover Collaborations. I made GIFs in Canva that show how the platform works and how to ultimately submit to the newsletter. So if you want to collaborate through Substack, it would be sweet if people can even submit guest posts, and that's totally possible. You just have to include a form. So this is a form that I included. I used a type form. I'll show you what that looks like real quick. So type form is just another application that lets you create forms. You can use Google Forms, whatever. Our form has a couple questions like your email, your public link to your hub, which is something you generate with your Kahana account, and then just a brief description of your collaboration, how many collaborators you want, total number of uploads you have, the goal for the project. This helps other people understand if they want to collaborate and they want to join. So this is our About page. It's a work in progress. We're going to ride with this at the very beginning, but we'll see if people get confused about it. We'll see if it works. A couple of things to notice about formatting an about page is that, and also Substack posts in general, is that you can add buttons like subscribe with caption, custom buttons. That's how I created the form button here. So I created a custom button that lets you have text in a specific URL. I'm not gonna do it now, but that's how you actually do it. You can also include a share publication button. So they have all these built-in buttons that you can use. There's also a couple more things like a divider that can help split everything up and make it easy to read. There's a paywall to include content that needs to be paid for. You can create a paywall that doesn't show it. It'll give you a slight snippet of the content and then people have to upgrade. You should upload a publication logo, a cover photo, and go and configure things correctly with respect to your mailing address, your copyrights if you have it. Your notifications can be modified here. So when you're formatting your posts, you can click posts here in your dashboard, and then here you'll see your drafts. So I've already created a draft and I'll show you what that looks like. So each of our posts is gonna be a list of hubs and collaborations, like I mentioned. So this is a hub that goes directly to the Future of Work hub called WorkKind. This is a link that goes to the Aquaculture hub. As you can see, there's descriptions here about what the collaboration is about. If you are on Twitter, you can take the embed code from your tweet and plop it into Substack and it'll just appear like this. I thought that was pretty interesting. The same thing will happen for YouTube videos. I'll just show you what that looks like real quick. All you have to do is take the YouTube video link. I'll just use this one for the sake of reference. When you take the link and you plop it in, boom, the YouTube video shows up. So if you're active on YouTube, you're trying to grow your channel, you want to allow your email list to also see videos and kind of get more views that way, you can totally use Substack for that. Thought that's pretty sweet, but I'm gonna not do that. That was just a reference. The last thing I want to mention to close out this video about Substack is the preview function. Very important, before you go off and publish, know that this is gonna send the post to everyone on your email list. So make sure you preview what it looks like. Substack lets you see what the post will look like on desktop and on mobile website version. So this is what it'll look like on the website. This is what it'll look like on the website on mobile. This is what it'll look like on mobile for an email. And one difference is that there's a footer section and a banner section. So I'll show you what that means in a second. This is what it looks like on email for desktop. It can get kind of confusing, but yeah, check. Make sure if you have to create a checklist about making sure everything looks good. Now, to modify the email header and footer, you can click this button from your post. You can also access this through your settings menu. I recommend a landscape kind of PNG. I went into Canva and built this out. I also created other infographics in Canva, downloaded them as PNGs, and then uploaded them to Substack. Now, in terms of modifying the email footer, I created a couple of bulleted lists of links that are important, and I just put it in the free subscriber email footer section. It gives you some default options here. So if you want to get more creative and you have specific things for your brand, I highly recommend going in and updating your header, footer, and banner. Very last thing I want to mention is that you can upload your own Excel or CSV here. You can start from your own email list, and you can also use Substack to grow your email list over time. Thank you so much for checking out this video. Substack honestly is a bit finicky and a bit tricky to figure out when you start, so don't get discouraged. Feel free to watch this video as many times as you want to go through and kind of update information. I hope that I did a decent job of explaining what's possible in Substack and the different components to making a publication run. We're about to launch this publication, so if you want to stay up to date and see how it goes, subscribe to our YouTube channel. I'll be posting more videos about Substack as we develop our publication, so you can totally just benefit from all the stuff that we do wrong. And if you like what you heard about our Substack publication and you want to collaborate in hubs, I'll include the link to join our email list in the description of this video. Thank you so much for checking this out, and I hope you have a great rest of your day. Bye.